this is Crunch, and today happens to be Tuesday. We're up in the woods where we get to celebrate the best of Nollywood, Hollywood, Bollywood, Gollywood, name it. Okay, my name is Wofai Samuel, and this is Nigezie, we're extremely Nigerian. Nollywood is just 20 years. But Nollywood has grown in leaps and bounds. Nollywood has become a major export product to the rest of the world. I mean, people get to meet and greet Nollywood celebrities, producers, directors, so many persons behind the cameras who get to make these movies, and they make us a huge success to the world at large. Today, we're going to be celebrating someone who's amiable. She's charismatic. She's charming. She's eloquent. She's a producer and as well a beautiful face in Nolly and Gollywood. She is none other than Juliet Ibrahim. Juliet Ibrahim happens to be one of the finest faces in Nigeria and Ghana from the stables of Nollywood and Gollywood. This is Nigezie TV, and I'm introducing to you Crunch. Of course, you know how it is, your one-stop favorite program in Nigezie, where you get to see different celebrities on a weekly basis, on a daily basis, come right here and talk about different issues affecting them, affecting the industry when you talk about entertainment and the media facets of life. Right about now, we have someone who is a brand ambassador, a movie actor, not just a movie actor, someone who is very outstanding in the way she carries herself. She's actually carved a niche for herself. She's contributed immensely when it comes to the Ghanian community, Nigerian community, and of course, the continent of Africa in general. I'm excited, pretty excited to have you here. Happy to host Juliet Ibrahim, one of Nollywood's finest, one of Africa's finest. You look pretty amazing, nice. Mm. Well put together outfit.
Thank you.
So why did you choose the whole denim, Jane thing?
Well, that's me. Like, because it's an interview, I have to go with some heels. Yeah, and then the jeans. And I think the blazer just to make me look more, you know, professional on screen.
You're so drawn into Nigerian entertainment. The journey into being a celebrity. How did it all start?
I think ever since I was born, to be a celebrity. I was like a lucky baby. Like my mom had me when she was still like she just graduated sort of, and then she fell in love. You know how it was, like you meet some guy and then you just fall in love, and then you get pregnant, and then you get married.
Wow.
And you just love this child, and you know, so that's like, okay, a star baby is born in the family. And I grew up, even though my growing up was a bit rough because of war, like we had to experience war in different countries, like when growing up, Liberia, Lebanon, Ivory Coast. Yeah.
Did you test the war?
Yes, I did.
Ooh.
Yeah. I still had the family love, like my sisters, my brother, my mom and dad were always there, like there for us. And even when I wanted to watch an Indian movie and sing along to the Indian songs, they'll always be there, encourage me. Yeah, you're doing so well and stuff like that. I even learned how to start speaking Hindi on my own just from watching movies. It started from then. That's when I knew that I actually wanted to be on TV or like be seen or appreciated, you know. I just used to like watching Hindi movies when I was growing up.
On a daily basis, we get to unravel the mysteries behind the different facets of Nigerian entertainment. Nollywood, we all know, is critical. It cannot be left out when you talk about Nigerian entertainment. And of course, Juliet Ibrahim has contributed immensely. Now she's delved from being an actor, being a producer, into being a musician. Now let's look at the entrepreneurial side of Juliet Ibrahim. Mm. Juliet Ibrahim has been an entrepreneur for, I wouldn't say a very long time, but for quite some time. Speak to us about that aspect of the year.
Even before acting, I was already running my beauty parlor in Ghana. And I happened to stumble into acting. And till now, I still am like a businesswoman. I love business. That you can meet me today, and if you're someone thinking like me, all we're going to talk about is business. What next?
Wow.
What we're going to do?
Amazing.
That's how I am. And I have people I've met, and they're like, you this girl, is that all you talk about? But what do you mean to talk about with you? Business. Because I believe that great minds think alike.
How do you look at yourself in the aspect of humanity?
Well, my foundation is like a kidney cancer awareness foundation. And we help people who have kidney failures or any kind of kidney disease.
That's a big one.
Yeah, to raise funds for them, and help pay their dialysis bills when, like, or if we can. That's because the two aunties of mine had kidney failures due to two different reasons. One had lupus and she fell out and it led to her kidney failing. And this one that had a lupus and now she lives with a kidney failure was the very first person that got me a job when I was looking for my very first job in her gym. And seeing that she was this strong person, energetic person, just happened to just break down, close down the gym and everything just because of a kidney failure. You have to pay for dialysis treatment 3 times a week and $100 a day. That's $100 a day. So it's hard, it's not easy, and that's what she's living on till date.
I'm sure there's so much to achieve. There's still hurdles you would cross.
Yeah.
Where do you see yourself in 3 years to come from now? Precisely 5 years from now, where do you see yourself?
Well, I always say this, I know I have a whole lot planned. Like you said, there's still things for me to do and places for me to go. But my target is to be listed among the top 10 most influential women in Africa on Forbes list.
Wow.
That's where I want to go. Or that's the path I'm on. That's the only thing I can say now. So the rest of the things I'm going to do to get me there will come out.
Everything is still a gradual process, right?
Yeah.
Okay, people who love me, I want to see more of you. How did they reach you? I need to give out your Twitter handles, your Facebook handles, your Instagram handles, and all of that.
Okay. You can follow me on Twitter at Juliet Ibrahim. Simple. And on Instagram, Juliet Ibrahim. Simple. On Facebook, my fan page on Facebook is Juliet Ibrahim Safo Original Fan Page. It has original fan page. Every other Juliet Ibrahim is fake. I have about 15 fake Facebook accounts.
Are you serious?
Yeah. So mine is the one with Juliet Ibrahim Safo Original Fan Page. I had to add the original just to make a difference. So I find people meeting me out there like, I've been chatting with you on Facebook, happy birthday. And my birthday is in March, not August or not July.
Okay.
So there are fake people on Facebook. On Twitter, it's just me, Juliet Ibrahim. I'm the only active one on there on Twitter.
Okay, yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah,
beautiful.
Always, every day I tweet. Every day I tweet.
Okay.
And on Instagram.
So you're a big fan of Twitter, right?
Yeah, Twitter and Instagram. I think Twitter is better. I'm not really a fan of Facebook anymore because what I tweet can go to Facebook.
Facebook, yeah.
When I post something on Facebook, it goes to Twitter. So I don't need to be going on only one. I just do that.
Today. Okay. Yeah. Now, away from the usual entertainment discussion, Juliet, you're on Crunch on Nigezie.
Yeah.
Where we get to host different celebrities on a weekly basis, on a daily basis as well. Now, what's your feel of the program? What can you say about this time out?
Well, I'm having fun. I'm having fun here and it feels good to be invited by you guys, and definitely I wouldn't mind coming again.
Wow, beautiful, beautiful. But I guess we have to plan better for the next interview.
Sure. I wouldn't mind coming again. Maybe after my movie is out or something and we can talk about it more, and maybe my next project, I have a reality TV show coming up. Or maybe my music video. You get to play my music video for them.
You have a video as well.
It's not out yet. I'm about to shoot it, but I have a song out.
I can imagine.
It's called Celebrate. Yeah, you know, I told you I wanted to be a musician.
You know, I know, but what would you be looking like in a music video?
Oh, hot. Nicki Minaj kind of thing.
The beautiful Juliet Ibrahim.
Nicki Minaj kind of thing.
So is it going to be crazy? Are you going to be doing the crazy
Yeah,
crazy
that's what
thingy?
I'm thinking about. It's called Celebrate, so I'm going to be celebrating life. The song, actually, if you listen to it or if you download it online, it's on iTunes as well. I'm celebrating what God has done for me. I think you get to hear from my lyrics the kind of person I am, sort of. Because I'm just appreciating what God has done for me. And I'm telling everybody to join me. And just, you know, have fun.
Beautiful, beautiful. It's actually been a wonderful time out here, Juliet. Your last words to your fans and everyone who loves you.
To my fans, I love you guys so much. Thanks for the support. My Nigerian fans watching, I'll be back on this show. But just make sure you keep requesting. I will come right back. Thanks so much for all the questions. I hope I answered everything you guys asked. And follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, wherever. I'll try my best to keep in touch with you.
Beautiful, beautiful. So, Juliet, this is Crunch on Nigezie. I needed to tell Africans, tell Nigerians how much you love Crunch.
Hi, my name is Juliet Ibrahim, and you're watching Crunch on Nigezie. I love this show.
Okay. Okay.